This is Anubhuti from sensitive.com. Welcome back to my channel, and today we are going to do a more chatty kind of video and going to do this makeup look. It's like an everyday wear fall makeup look using only Sugar Cosmetics products. So this is going to be more of a first impression, come to chatty, get ready with me kind of video. Because I have not used many of the products, I will be using them for the very first time here with all of you. So yes, stay tuned and let's begin. I have cleaned my face and then moisturized it, so I think we can start right away. Since Sugar Cosmetics do not have any makeup primer available, and plus I personally do not like to wear primers on day to day basis, so we are going to start off with base. So we are going to start with BB cream. So this is Goddess of Flawless SPF 30 plus BB cream. This is shade 01 latte, and this is the lightest shade I believe it comes. This is newly launched and I have not used it because I like to apply BB cream with my hands. Oh, this is quite smooth, like this feels quite lightweight on my hands. So we are going to just, oh my god, this spreads like dream. This really does spread like a dream, and this is a perfect shade match. I hope you can see. BB cream was like cream, and as soon as I applied it on my face, it set to that powdery matte finish, so which is something I really like. I'm going to take a little bit more, and we are going to skip concealer since Sugar do not have any concealer. So I'm just going to apply a little more on the areas where I need to conceal, like. So the coverage is not much, I would say. It's like perfect for everyday wear kind of coverage. And yes, on layering, I have applied almost 1.5 layer, and it is not feeling heavy at all. I'm going to take a little bit more and just on my neck. So, as you can see, there is not much coverage. You can see a little bit of my pimples popping through, but I like such coverage for everyday wear. So. Yeah, definitely good for everyday wear, but you might not be able to skip concealer if you have pigmented skin and you like that flawless finish or coverage, so you are going to just not like that. So yeah, the BB cream is done, and for setting my face, I have combination skin, which tends to get oily still, which tends to get oily on few areas like here and here. I still like to set my face with powder. So I'm going to use Sugar As Nude As It Gets Compact. This is again shade 01 Latte, which is the lightest shade. And also comes in a packaging like this, like matte packaging. And when you open it, there is a puff inside, there is a mirror inside, and then there is the product. So yeah, I'm going to use the puff so that we get to know how the everything performs. Okay, so the powder is finely milled. There is not much of the kickbacks. So I'm going to apply the side with using puff and another side using my powder brush. Okay, so the puff picks up good amount of product. The powder is smooth, very finely milled, and seems very fine. Not sure how it performs on this one. Coverage is low to medium. I'm going to take my powder brush and okay, so I have swirled my powder brush, and you can see there is like not much kickback. Okay, it picked quite decent amount of product. So the compact is done. For some blush, so I'm going to use the newly launched blush minis, and this is the shade contour de force mini blush 02 pink pinnacle. So this is a purple pink mauvey toned blush, which looks gorgeous. This is how it looks. Like, there's the plastic sheet over the product, and this is how it looks in the packaging. This is quite mini, if you can see. This is like really mini size, but again, blush is like enough. This is how much you can use. So this is the product. This is perfect, that mauvey plum shade, perfect for like winters, falls. I love such shades, and these are perfect for everyday wear. So let me swatch it. So this is the shade. Again, the pigmentation is quite good. I hope you can see that I have swatched it here. So this is just one swipe, and you can always build it up. So this is like perfect flop for blush. I'm going to take my Real Techniques blush brush, because Sugar does not have any tools yet. Okay, so again, there is not much kickback, but very little I can see. And then I'm going to apply. Okay, I need mirror. This is pretty color. I hope you can see the difference. This is really pretty. This is really pretty and really pigmented. Beautiful. There is a little bit kickback, but not much. It gives that perfect winter flush to your cheeks. So this, okay. So the blush is done. I'm going to skip contouring or bronzing on every day, for everyday kind of look. Now the base is done. This is pretty much it. And yeah, the face is done. Now we're going to shift to eyes, and for that I'm going to use Blenderoos Eyeshadow Quad by Sugar. This is in number 02, Belief, and this one has again beautiful mauvey plummy shades, which I absolutely adore. There is like this kind of sponge applicator eyeshadow application, but I do not use this. And you can see that this is like pretty much the quad. Okay, first let me show you all the four shades. These are the four shades. This is the new one, mauvey nude, and this is the rose gold with plum undertones, and this is plum. And if I swatch it, look at the pigmentation. It's like pretty pigmented. Even for a nude shade, there is white pigmentation. So again, let me pick up my eyeshadow brushes, and we are going to start. First, I'm going to take this beautiful nude color, and I'm going to take it on a fluffy brush, and I'm just going to apply it. There is a lot of kickback. I'm not sure if you can see, but there is a lot of product kickback on this. There is no mirror in this quad, which I find a little bit disappointing. Also, I really like the quality of the mirror which they have included in the matte. So I'm going to use that. Okay, so for the matte shade, the pigmentation is quite nice. So I'm going to use use that nude color all over my lid. I have applied that new eyeshadow all over my lid, and that is going to act as a base for my eye look. And now I'm going to take a flat brush, and I'm going to take that mauve pink shade and apply it on the lids. I'm going to apply this on outer half of the eye. These shadows are really, really pigmented. Now I'm going to take the blending brush, take the nude on the brush again, and just blend everything. So that's pretty much blended. I'm just going to take that same brush again, clean it on a tissue paper. Flat brush, I'm going to take this rose gold kind of this rose gold shade on the brush and just pat it slightly, very so slightly, in the inner corners. Not much, just very lightly. Okay, so the satiny shadows are not giving that much pigmentation when I'm using it with the brush. I'm going to use my finger. Yeah, that's a lot better. Okay, again I'm going to take the same blending brush, taking a little bit new on it, and just blend everything. I don't want a very intense satiny look, so I'm just going to blend everything. Okay, I'm going to take a thick, brush, and I'm going to take the mauve shade, and I'm just going to bring it in the lower lash line. I'm not going to bake or anything that sort, because that is not my everyday look. So the eyes are done. Time for brows. Brows, I'm going to use a Sugar Arch Rival Brow Definer in shade 02 Taupe Tom, which is like a grayish brown shade. I have like naturally blackish brown hair, so I find these kind of shades perfectly match for me. So this is how it looks. It's like a triangle end at one side and the spoolie brush on the other side. Packaging is again same as like matte black, and there is not much pigmentation when you swatch it, so which is perfect because you do not want too much creamy product on your brows. So I'm just going to fill my gaps, and I'm just going to define my brows. And you can see what difference does filling a brow makes. So I'm just going to do the same on the other side. So the eyeshadows and brows are done. Time for tight lining my eyes, and for that I'm going to use a Sugar Twist and Shout Fade Proof Kajal in shade 01 Black Velvet. And I like to wear this. Is how it looks. This is quite a bit old product, so yeah, I think you might already have known. I'm going to use this to tight line my eyes. I really, really love this kajal. This like doesn't smudge on me, so yeah, we have to use. So I have tight lined my eyes. For eyeliner, I'm going to use their for eyeliner I'm going to use the Arrested for Overstay waterproof eyeliner in shade 01. I'll be black. So this is like those pen kind of eyeliners, and this is like black, but I think this is like a shiny black. So I'm just going to do my eyeliner now. So the liner is done. Now time for mascara, and Sugar has a mascara from the range, but I do not have it, so I'm going to just apply my Maybelline Falsies. That's like my favorite mascara. So okay, so the mascara is also done. Okay, now I'm going to take my powder brush. This is like empty. I'm just going to swirl everything, just to make sure everything is okay. Time for some lipstick. For that, I'm going to use Meta's Hell Crayon in shade 14 Violet Crawley. I'm just going to take tissue paper and blot my lips. Take out extra lip balm and just apply lip crayons. Okay, so I'm going to take my lip brush because I seem to have damaged my crayon. I'm just going to line my lips. And this is done. Okay, so the lipstick is also done. You might be wondering, this is a quite dark purple shade. Yes, it is. Yes, and it is very much wearable also. If you're thinking to wear it to office, you can definitely, yes, because we are keeping the rest of the makeup very normal. This is the final look. I hope you enjoy it. So that's my everyday fall makeup look, which I have done using Sugar Cosmetics product. First impression was quite good on few products like BB cream, compact and blush I've used for the very first time. I'm not feeling any tackiness on my skin right now, or no kind of oiliness. So that's really, really good. Also, I can see the blush is really pretty and very subtle for every day. I have applied a Violet Crawley on my lips. Again, all the product names will be in the description box below, so you can check it out. So, yeah, that's all from my side. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Do not forget to subscribe to my channel and visit my website, sunsteed.com. If you would want me to do more such videos, please mention in the comment section below, and I would love to do it for you guys. Till next time, bye-bye.